Good morning, fans of Privateer FX. Coming at you with the European Open here. Just scanning through the newspapers and the news feeds and the charts. Looks like we're moderately risk-on today. I guess the most conventional piece of news is the trade war is kind of simmering to a close. Dollar yen looks in play. Printed 88 high overnight, which matches the 90 high on February 20th. It's a huge pivot here. We all remember the breakdown from 108.08. We're going to attack this level today, it looks like. 10-year yield, 297. It's pretty serious. Moderately risk on. Yes, trading at 2680, but quietly 2680. Dollar yen and dollar Swiss are going to have a hard time resisting these yields, so even though we've had many, many up days here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this looks like it's set to continue. 98.50 definitely looks like in the cards in dollar Swiss, so we're buyers of dollars today. You want to be long dollar yen for the inevitable momentum trades that will be at 91 and at 01. I was suggesting to a colleague that 04 might be the number today in dollar yen, 108.04. So we print 04 in Europe, we screw around a little bit, and then New York takes the baton and smashes it higher. Let's see how that goes, but we're quietly long dollars today. And that's our focus. You gotta wonder what's gonna happen with this CAD yen and Aussie yen that broke down on Friday. It seems likely that these guys are gonna get stopped out. I don't really know what the trade is here, because technically it's not that great, but if you still are short CAD yen or Aussie yen from the Friday breakdowns, I'd be careful with that. We're square here at the moment. Cryptos are bid, almost 9,000 now. Bitcoin, not much of a trade strategy there. We're just waiting for the next negative news flow to buy again, and then just trying to trade this from the long side. It's a very long-term trade. So basically, it's pretty simple strategy in what is inevitably going to be a very quiet European session, as it has been for weeks now. Try and get long some dollars. Keep an eye on that 10-year yield. If we do close above 3%, it'll be very, very important. All right, guys. Good luck out there. Talk to you at the New York Open. Ciao.